Hello, cyber citizens. Welcome to What the Science, the place where you get your answers with the science behind it. This is Facto Science. In this section, we explain the science behind mysteries, fiction, technology, etc. Before starting with the topic, here is Facto Science question. Name the animal species in which the male partner gives birth to young ones instead of female. Stay tuned to find out the correct answer. And now get ready to flex your brain muscles because we are going to get started. Gold is one of the rarest elements available on Earth. And also one of the costliest. It is one of the most on-demand elements, not only due to its aesthetic value but also due to its property as a metal. Gold is the most malleable of all metals. A single gram can be beaten into a sheet of 1 square meter. Gold leaf can be beaten thin enough to become semi-transparent. Such semi-transparent sheets also strongly reflect infrared light, making them useful as infrared shields in visors of heat-resistant suits and in sun visors for spacesuits. Gold is also a very good conductor of heat and electricity and has high corrosion resistance as compared to copper. So there have been numerous efforts to create gold in the laboratory using many crazy experiments. But as far as we know, none of them worked out. There are high deposits of gold in the oceans, but mining gold from ocean bed is not so economical. Creating gold in a lab was considered as a fancy story till we met Cupriavidus metallidurans. Cupriavidus metallidurans, or C. metallidurans, is a rod-shaped bacterium which primarily lives in soils that are enriched with numerous heavy metals. Over time, some minerals break down in the soil and release toxic heavy metals and hydrogen into their environment. According to Professor Dietrich H. Nies, a microbiologist at MLU, apart from the toxic heavy metals, living conditions in these soils are not bad. There is enough hydrogen to conserve energy and nearly no competition. If an organism chooses to survive here, it has to find a way to protect itself from these toxic substances. In 2009, Professor Dietrich, together with his Australian counterpart, Professor Frank Reith from the University of Adelaide, was able to prove that C. metallidurans is able to deposit gold biologically. But the exact process that take place in this gold formation remained unknown. But now the researchers have finally been able to solve the mystery. The soil in these areas have deposits of gold and copper. Gold enters the bacteria the same way as copper. Copper is a vital trace element for C. metallidurans, however it is toxic in large quantities. When the copper and gold particles come into contact with the bacteria, a range of chemical processes occur. Copper usually occurs in a form that is difficult to be digested. So it is converted to a form that is considerably easier for the bacterium to import. And thus is able to reach the interior of the cell. The same also happens to the gold compounds. When too much copper has accumulated inside the bacteria, it is normally pumped out by the enzyme called CUPA. However, the presence of gold compounds suppresses the enzyme. Thus, the toxic copper and gold compounds remain inside the cell. Copper and gold combined are actually more toxic than when they appear on their own. To solve this problem, the bacteria activates another enzyme called CUPA. This enzyme transforms the copper and gold compounds into their originally difficult to absorb forms. This assures that fewer copper and gold compounds enter the cellular interior. The bacterium is poisonless. And the enzyme that pumps out the copper can dispose off the excess copper. Now the gold compounds that are difficult to absorb are transformed into harmless gold nuggets in the outer area of the cell. These nuggets are only a few nanometers in size. In nature, C. metallidurans plays a key role in the formation of so-called secondary gold. It transforms the toxic gold particles formed by the weathering process into harmless gold particles, thereby producing gold nuggets. So even if we are more developed and complex organisms as compared to sea metallidurans, the tiny bacteria can do things that no man ever could. Thus once again proving the superiority of nature itself. So that's it from this episode of Facto Science. You can watch other episodes by clicking on the link above. And if you liked the episode, hit the thumbs up button to let us know. If you have any comments, suggestions and ideas for future episodes, please comment below. And don't forget to subscribe, because we make videos every week. Also please to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we post a new video. You can also follow us on Twitter. And do like our Facebook page. All the links are provided in the description below. Thank you for watching. Coming back to our Facto Science question. The answer is seahorses. Female seahorses impregnate the male mates, and the male gives birth to young ones. Seahorses are the only animal on Earth where the male bears the unborn young. Hope this video created a spark in your gray cells and helped you to understand the intricacies. We will meet again soon with another video. Till then, stay curious and keep learning.